This is Dr. Bamberg at the University of Utah. Welcome back to our series on the ABCs of design. Today we will discuss the compute and construct portion, specifically focusing on the computation aspects. An important aspect of design is using computational models to understand how your system will behave. Mathematical models are a formulation or system of equations that allow us to express the features of a physical system. Note that these typically involve some assumptions about your system. For a particular design, we might need to optimize a particular variable that is dependent on other parameters, such as independent variables, fixed system parameters, or forcing functions. When modeling an aspect of your design, you need to be very methodical. To assist in keeping the modeling for the competition focused, you should ask the following questions to keep your modeling efficient and on track. What number are you trying to calculate with this modeling? Once you find this number, how will it help your design process? How will you find this number? Think about whether you're following the standard problem-solving procedure that we've taught you in class. And what information or values do you need before you can find this number? Asking these questions will save you time by helping you avoid modeling to obtain numbers that you don't really need to help design or understand your system. It will also help you avoid being inefficient by not following the standard procedure, which can end up with you using the wrong equations or inappropriately applying the correct equations. All right, in MU1000, you will be modeling your potential energy system. You will report on your results in your upcoming DPA 8. As a simple example, note that you are constrained to 2 spam can meters worth of potential energy. This gives you 2 variables that you can choose, the mass and the height. Of course, one of these is independent and one is dependent. For example, we can write the equation for potential energy and set it equal to our constraint. Then we can either choose mass to be our dependent variable as a function of height, or choose height to be our dependent variable as a function of mass. Coming up in class, we'll teach you how to take these 2 variables along with other design variables to model your entire potential energy system and use that model to make design decisions. Thanks for listening!